Okay, welcome, Shalom. This is the brother Lamadia once again coming back in the spirit of Yahweh by Hashem Yahushah, by Hashem Rokach Wadash. And this that we're looking at on the screen was a post that I seen on Instagram. And, you know, which we understand that all of this is BS. And we understand the basic scriptures. But what got me was the comments that was left under this post. But first, what I want to do is I'm going to read what's on the screen, and then we're going to go to the comments. So on the screen, it reads, "Body of Jesus found." Now it says, "European explorers discovered the body in the desert of Western China, along with a crowbar that anthropologists believe was used to pry him off the cross. The naturally mummified remains, desecrated by the desert, exude a fainted bread-like aroma." And you know Esau set these things up to try to reinforce Christianity, because Christianity is on ICU right now. So all of this is being done out of desperation. So now let's do this. Let's show the comments now that was left behind by Jakes in the world. So let's start with this. DJ 100, "Another Esau law." Now, I don't understand what he mean by law, but, you know, the fact that he laboring this as Esau shows that he's familiar who are the Edomites. Because this knowledge of the scriptures are now, especially when it comes to the description of Yahushua, has become global. So next one from _Symphony_, and it says, "Hair don't look like wool." And that's pursuing to Revelation the 13 and 4, Revelation the first chapter in the 13 and 14 verse, where it gives the description of Yahushua hair as wool. So then now, once again, these are all Jakes writing this, and these are Jakes in the world that's in darkness. Now, Mrs._Robinson_29 wrote, "He's white again? ... Other words, saying that he's the opposite. He's not a white man. He's a so-called Negro. This from What's Living My Life G. He put a couple emojis, like a fainting emoji. Then you have a couple laughing emojis. And he wrote, "Y'all will make up anything to make him non-black." Joe_Centaro, "Caesar Borgia or Cesare Borgia was headed to the Chinese buffet." So what do you learn about Cesare Borgia? From the Israelites. He definitely didn't learn this from the Christian church. Now, even down here it says Fairy Hansan. "What kind of host is this?" Laughing emojis. Now it says, from the person with the bald head and the gray no soup. Ill vibes. He wrote, nope, underscore, it's like it, nope, and thumbs down, it's like it. He doesn't look like burnt brass. Again, pursuing to Revelation, the first chapter, in the 13 and 14 verse. And these are all common folks. These are all Jake. Because I tell you this, 20, 30 years ago, this information wasn't as broad. Even 40 years ago, the information wasn't as broad. But now, being that we at the end, this is considered common information. That's why Christianity is dying. And Elder Apostle Hart always say this, that Christianity is a dying breed. That's why you have Vocab Malone. Because Vocab Malone's aim is to reinforce Christianity and bring Jake back into this darkness. Now, this is from a woman named Creole.Hippie. Don't look like no hair like wool to me. Other words saying that the Lord is a so-called Negro. And he had hair like wool. That he wasn't a so-called white man. Then you have a guy here, Honorable C. Note. He wrote Cap. Now, Cap is just a slang that Jake used going back to the West Coast. It's an old school term going back to the West Coast. And that's something used to say as something not real, or a person lying, or something that's fake, or somebody faking. Because it goes back to the word cap gun. Because, you know, back in the days, which you don't really see it like that no more, but back in the days you had cap, a lot of time kids would play with cap guns, which was fake guns. And it shot out blanks. So that became a slang as, you know, cap. Something that's fake. So that's what we have here from the comments. So now we're going to go to Matthew, Salakia 24 and 14. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations. And what's the gospel? The gospel means good news. What's the good news? That this current world is going to go down. And the Lord's people is going to rise up into power and authority. But first, it must be destruction before there is construction. Because the Lord coming back to destroy this place. Simultaneously, when the missiles get shot off to destroy this place. But the gospel is, or the good news is, that all is not going to be destroyed. And the Lord set up an election that will be delivered. So again, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto all nations. And then shall the end come. Now the key word is the end. So the fact that the world is familiar with the Lord being a so-called Negro is a witness that we at the end. Because that shows that the world had heard the gospel. Whether if they accepted or didn't accept it, or if they accepted partially of it. You know, the Lord, they still heard the word. And each person is going to be accountable for what they was taught. So we at the end, and it's coming. Psalms 5:5, the foolish shall not stand in thy sight. Thou hatest all workers of iniquities. Who the workers of iniquity are, is Esau or Edom, the so-called white race. You know, they known as the workers of iniquity or the wicked. But even our people has became more wicked than the wicked himself. Because our people are more devilish than the devil. So that's why the Lord, he's going to have to do an ethnic cleansing and destroy 2/3 of his own people. Thou shalt destroy them that speak leasing. The Lord will abhor the bloody and deceitful man. And that's the so-called white man. 2 Corinthians 13:8. But we can do nothing against the truth, but for the truth. And I believe it was Elder Apostle Ram Lab that had made this analogy with the bouncing ball. If you was to take a bouncing ball and try to sink it underwater, what's going to happen is the more force that you try to push it down into the water, or more resistance you try to push it down, the more resistance you're going to get, and it's going to pop back up, back to the surface even higher. And that's the same with this knowledge. This knowledge cannot be stopped. But we can do nothing against the truth, but for the truth. And again, that's why you have men like Vocab, Malone, because they trying to stop the word of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah. But the more they try to stop it, the more this gospel expands. Now, this is the book of Colossians 1:25. Whereof I am made a minister according to the dispensation of the Most High, which is given to me for you, to fulfill the word of the Most High, even the mysteries which has been hid from ages. Now, what's the mysteries? The mystery is the things that are comprised of the scriptures. Because a lot of people go into the Bible, a lot of people don't understand the Bible, because the Bible was written in cryptic form, and only the elect will be able to understand it. What's comprised of the mystery? The image of the Lord, prophecies, who the Israelites are, the MOTB. These are all comprised of the mysteries. And it says, which has been hid from ages and from generations, but now is made manifest to his saints. Now, those people that was on a comic boy, even though they're not of the elect, well, I won't say that. Even though they're in darkness, rather, because I don't know if they are the elect, and the Most High could wake them up. But my point is, even though they are in darkness, they still Israelites. But the saints are Israelites. And that much they know, the image of the Lord. Am I saying they're going to be delivered? Of course not. Because if they're not right with the Most High, it don't matter if they know the image of the Lord or the description of the Lord. You're not right with the Most High, so you're going to be destroyed. But they're still Israelites, and they understand this. So it says, to whom the Most High will make known what is the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles. And the word Gentile simply just means strangers. And we all became Gentiles, technically, because none of us could really say we was born in the land of Israel. A lot of us was born in America or the Caribbean islands or the UK or other parts of the earth. And we came back into our identity. We had to relearn who we were. But the mystery was revealed unto us so that we can call on the name of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shah. And it says, which is Yahweh Shah, which is Yahweh Shah in you, the hope of glory. So with that, in closing, I'm going to say, first, go ahead and subscribe to this channel and the backup channel that we have, GMS Playtime Over 2, in case this, you know, channel get taken down. You can always have GMS Playtime Over 2. And I'm going to say all praises and glory to Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh Shah, by Hashem Rukaku Dash Shalawam.